But I think it's going to be a close fight. I think Plant's going to make it very difficult with his boxing skills and his movement and his ability to box and outbox and use his jab and stuff. His feet worked very good, so I think it's going to be a very tricky fight. I think Canelo might get the points decision, but I wouldn't rule out Caleb Plant, and I wouldn't be surprised if Caleb Plant causes, which would be an upset if he gets a decision.
How's your knee feeling, Josh?
It's getting better. It's just, you know, I can't do certain weights in my S&C, certain exercises. I can't run properly at the minute either, so which is a massive part of my training, which is running, how you get the condition, the S&C stuff, which is a massive part of my programme as well. I can't do properly or too fully, so I had to put the fight back, you know. So we're getting a lot of physio and a lot of work on it at the minute, so we'll be ready for February 26th.
Josh, we were here at the press conference for Jojo Diaz, Devin Haney. Break that fight down for us. It's going to happen December 4th.
I'm not really sure, you know. I think I'll probably edge towards Haney. His slick boxer, slick skills, very clever as well. So I'd probably back Haney on that one.
Now, going back to, you know, Canelo Caleb Plant takes place tomorrow here in Las Vegas. What qualities do you think Caleb Plant that could probably overdo for Canelo?
I just think his speed, his timing, his feet work. Canelo seems to always have a little bit of problems with people that can move around a little bit, you know, use the feet work to their advantage. He always has a little bit of trouble dealing with that. He always gets the win. He always figures it out and stuff in the end, but he always seems to have a little bit of trouble. But I think Canelo will get the points win in the end, but for the first half of the fight, I think it'll be tricky.
Yesterday, we were at Teofimo's Lopez media workout, and he said in the future he would like to.